What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about how to format an USB device within Ubuntu using GParted. So let's get right into it. All right, so today is all about taking a USB flash drive, it could be anything that you want, and reformatting it within a Ubuntu Linux environment. I like using Ubuntu. That's the first Linux, you know, distro that I have used since the beginning, using GParted. So I am actually going to plug it in into my laptop. Let's plug it in. Beep. And it's going to mount it. We just heard the blink. It's mounted right there. There goes our flash drive. Awesome. Now, the utility GParted is not part of Ubuntu, so we need to install it. So open up a command prompt. I'm already logged in as a root, so I don't need to enter sudo to, you know, elevate the commands. From here, first thing that we need to do is app get update. Always make sure you got the latest update. Get all the repos. It's reading the packages. I don't have much because I do it almost all the time. Next command would be app get upgrade and hit enter. Great. Everything is upgraded. Everything is updated. I don't have much. Now, let's clear this up. And the command to actually install the utility would be app install GParted and hit enter. Now, I already have it installed within my machine, so I don't really need to, you know, download it and install it. But for you, most likely you don't have it. Just run this command, follow the prompt. I think it will ask you something. Just hit yes and it will install it. Now, to get started, super simple. Let's clear our prompt and just type in GParted and just hit enter. As soon as you hit enter, it gives you this nice graphical interface that allows you to partition and create partition tables within that flash drive, which is great. Now, by default, it is going to show you your local hard drive. We don't want that. So on the upper right-hand side, let's click on this drop-down right here and pick your hard drive or pick your flash drive. My flash drive is about 15, 16 gigs or something like that. So I'm going to select it and there it goes. Now, by default, you're not able to do anything on the flash drive. So if I right click on it, I'm not able to delete it. I'm not able to resize it or do anything. You need to unmount it. So let's unmount. And as soon as it unmounts, check this out. As soon as you select it, you have options. Now you have things to do. So I'm actually going to right click on it and I'm going to delete it. Boom. As soon as you delete it, again, make sure you back up whatever you have inside that flash drive. If it's gibberish that you don't need, hey, delete it. Go for it. You don't need to back it up. But as soon as you delete it, it becomes allocated. And when it becomes allocated, this is where it allows you to partition it to, you know, whatever you want. So let's right click on it. And now you have the option to do new. So click on new. And this is where you are able to play with the sizes. So you are able to use the slider here, which is pretty cool. I'm just going to play around with the size. I think it's 16 gigs. So let's give it 8196. I think it's close to 8 gigs, right? Let me see something. Let's go here. Let's type in the calculator. Get the trusty calculator. Yes, I think one gig is 1024, right? Let's times that by 8, 8192. That's around 8 gigs. Beautiful. And we are going to just leave I'm going to leave everything as is and the primary. And you are able to click on the file system and pick what type of system that you want. Now, if you're going to be using this flash drive within a Linux environment constantly, hey, keep it as EXT4. If you're going to be using it within the Windows environment, you could do NTFS. I think NTFS will allow you to do PC as well as the Linux environment, but it's up to you. We're going to do NTFS format, and let's click apply. Great. And we are going to click on the check mark. Okay, so once you do all that, like the partition is not really set. You got to click on that green check mark to actually apply the settings. You're going to get this nice little warning. We're going to click apply and it's going to start creating our partition, the first partition. Now, because this is around 15, 16 gigs, I still have extra allocated space, which once this is done, and we are able to actually click on details, and it tells you what's happening. Green check mark. Excellent. Let's close it. Now we have 8 gigs. Beautiful. We're able to store stuff now inside that 8 gigs, but we still have this allocated space, which you're able to do something to it. So let's do something. Let's click on new and check this out. We are going to, let's use the rest of it. This is 6 gigs. Let's do, I think we are able to Let's, you want to give it 2 gigs? Let's do 2 gigs just for the hell of it. So that would be what? 2048. We're going to do the file system. We're going to leave it as an ext4. We're going to click on add and it created our second partition. And now that gives us an additional 4.90 allocated space that we could play around with. Once you make the changes, you give it the space and you change the file system, make sure you click on the green check mark to apply it. Click apply and your second partition is being created. Looks like it froze a little bit. It's okay. Click on details. It's still processing and working its magic. But now we have two partitions. We have the first partition, which is formatted as an NTFS. And the second partition that we created would be formatted as an EXT4 format, which is great. And I still have extra space on this flash drive. And that's it, guys. That is how we use GParted within Ubuntu. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out. Yes, and it just finished right now. Great. Later.